spending the last eight seasons in Hamilton, Brandon Banks gets to experience the Tiger Cats Argos rivalry as a member of the Double Blue, no doubt looking for a huge game against his former team. But it won't be easy against this Hamilton defense, especially because they are welcoming this guy, Simone Lawrence, back into the fold after he missed the past four games with that groin injury. Hello, Canada, and welcome to the CFL on TSN. Kate Burness alongside David Sanchez, Matt Dunnigan, Milt Stegall, as we get set for a doubleheader on this Saturday night.
Let's go.
And let's start with the key matchups. We got the rivalry back. They'll be facing each other four out of the next 5 weeks. Who do you like in this one, Chess?
You know what? The Argos tackles Phillip Blake and Shane Richards. They're going to have their hands full tonight, and they got to keep Macbeth clean. And this has got some pretty good ends, and there's a pretty good inside guy right there in Dylan Wynn. But Julian Howser and the guys on the outside, they got to take care of those guys in order for Macbeth to have success.
I think Dane Evans' go-to guy has been Stephen Dunbar this year. Second-year receiver is coming into his own. He's going to be challenged. McFadden kicks out from halfback to corner. Watch that matchup along with Jamal Peters on the other side as well. So Stephen Dunbar is having a great season, seventh in the league in receiving.
Right.
Got to step up to the plate again against the arch rivals.
We have some big personalities in this league, but one of the biggest personalities is Simone Lawrence. He's been out four games, and I know he's been itching to get back, not only just to make plays, but you know he likes to talk. Another guy who likes to talk is Andrew Harris, and these two guys will be going against each other. Of course, the entire linebacking corps, Santos, Knox, and Kelly, they're going to aim to stop him, but Simone Lawrence, I know he's looking to make some big plays against his guys, so I'm looking for that matchup and how it's going to happen when those two guys bang with each other.
How about with Speedy going up against that secondary?
Oh, yeah.
I know this as a guy that's been in that DB receiver. A lot of times, and receivers are talking, you can't hit them. We can't hit them
in practice.
We can't hit you in practice.
No.
So guys will, you know, Speedy tells the guys, I'm going to run by you. If this was a game, I'll toast you. And on the other end, those defensive backs want
to
hit
you. Now you're going to get a chance to find out.
He's at the mercy of play calling, too,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's like, so you want to make an impact and you want to do it early. It could be the third quarter, fourth quarter, like Jaden Acklin last night.
Ryan
before you see a ball.
Ryan Dinwiddie, he's going to give him some opportunities.
Yeah, I hope so.
He's going to get some opportunities.
Because we got Speedy B on the over, right?
Yep.
Speaking of that, you guys have not been overly successful on the same game parlays, but I'm feeling it tonight. So let's take a look at game number one. We're going to do the later game a little later on. Curley Gittens Jr., you have him on the over tonight, Chez. Matt, like McLeod Bethel Thompson over the 266.5. Mm-hmm. Milt, you like Brandon Banks to torch his former team over that 34.5.
Let's hope.
If all three hit, are you ready for this? You're looking at plus 359. Gentlemen, I like that. And I like that it's a beautiful night at BMO Field. It is the Tiger Cats and the Argonauts coming up next on TSN.
You've got your
Save On Foods $1 million touchdown to win. If a kickoff is returned for a touchdown, you could win groceries for a year. If two kickoffs are returned for touchdowns, you could win $1 million. Good luck, Cheryl. Let's get you to BMO Field and join Rod Smith and Dwayne Ford.
Thank you, Kate, and we welcome everyone to, a hot, scorching summer night in southern Ontario, and the perfect symbol for a heated rivalry in the case of the Hamilton Tiger Cats and Toronto Argonauts. This will be the first of four meetings over the course of the next month. They say familiarity breeds contempt, Wayne. It actually feeds contempt in this case. And the last time they met here back in December, Brandon Banks was on the other side. This has got to be a strange feeling for him tonight.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. A guy who has been raised in the Canadian Football League to hate the Toronto Argonauts as far as this rivalry goes, suddenly finds himself this season on the other side of it, playing against his longtime teammates in black and gold, and none he knows better than this guy, Simone Lawrence, who makes his return to the Ticats lineup just in time to see how effective he is at getting under the skin of one of his best friends in the league, Speedy B.
So he'll go through the experience of facing his old team for the first time. Next week, next Friday, he'll go through the experience of playing them at his old stomping grounds at Tim Hortons Field. The Ticats won the toss but deferred. The Argos taking the ball. Dejon Brissette has it, and he comes across the 20 for Toronto up near the 25, where McLeod Bethel Thompson will go to work.
But
McLeod Bethel-Thompson fresh off a game against the Ottawa Red Blacks in which he put up big numbers, 340 yards passing in that one, 25 completions. But the Argos unable to secure victory in that one. So he looks to certainly reverse that trend, especially with their heated division rivals here in town tonight.
There is an injured player for the Ticats. That is running back Sean Thomas Erlington, injured on the kick coverage. Several times this season, the starting running back. In this case today, he is second in the depth behind Don Jackson. But every team has certainly seen their share of injuries, and that includes Orlando Steinauer, as Thomas Erlington is still down.
Well, that'll create some complications for the Ticats, as Thomas Erlington, though he's not listed as the starting running back, is certainly a guy who plays his share of reps, takes his share of snaps in that Hamilton offense. So a little bit bigger load certainly falling on Don Jackson, and I suspect some personnel packages that may be out of the mix for the Tiger Cats.
In his third season out of the University of Montreal Carabin program. You see Orlando Steinauer had gone out. Personally to check in. See Thomas Erlington. Good to see the movement. Check the neck area and the kickoff coverage.
We'll keep an eye right here on number 31 in white. That's Thomas Erlington getting down on the kick cover team. As he comes off the block, he's going to get kind of clipped here by his teammate Grant McDonald, who's coming down in coverage. Obviously neither one seeing the other. Just had his head snapped back to the left there. Certainly good to see some movement from Sean.
As the Ticat medical staff continue to tend to Sean Thomas Erlington, a very, very hot day, as mentioned off the top, here in Toronto. There's Don Jackson, the starting running back, as the applause comes from fans here at BMO Field. But the first of four meetings, they meet again at Tim Hortons Field next week. And again, before Labor Day, the Labor Day Monday game a month from now will be the last of four. But slow to get this one started with the injury, understandably, as he is sitting up now. A very good sign as they help him to his feet to more applause.
Great sign to see him on his feet and making his way to the sidelines under his own power.
And so the Argos have the ball first. Simone Lawrence back after missing a month with injury, his first game back. With his old friend, his good friend Brandon Banks on the other side. Bethel Thompson last week in a losing cause against Ottawa, 25 of 39 for 340. A touchdown pass to Brandon Banks. None intercepted. But the Argos did lose that game. They fell to 3-3. 2 points ahead of Hamilton and Montreal in that East Division. First and 10 to 26. And that's Andrew Harris, the ball carrier. Picks up a couple of yards. Harris only had 17 yards last week against the Red Blacks and did a great job against them. We look at the Argo offense, brought to you by Expedia.
Yeah, and a lot of injuries for the Argos, particularly along that offensive line. So you'll see Canadians Philip Blake at left tackle. Shane Richards, number one pick in 2019, gets a start at right tackle. Calgarian. And in the receiving corps, we get to see number 24, Aaron Rodgers, 31-year-old veteran out of Cal Lutheran, former Calgary Stampeder, makes his first appearance of the season.
So second down and eight after the 2 yards by Harris, nearly intercepted. Ciante Evans, the field corner coming in, jumping that route, and he nearly had a big defensive play to start things off for Hamilton.
Looking at the matchup on the outside, and Ciante Evans, number 7 at the bottom of your screen, is going to get a fantastic jump on this route. Coming underneath, but just losing that one off the fingertips.
John Haggerty punts it away. Lawrence Woods with a game-time decision in the lineup on the return. And a good return here across the Hamilton 45, where Dane Evans will come in, coming off a victory over the Alouettes, where he shared some of the time with Matthew Schiltz. He was 13 of 18 for 206, a touchdown, no picks last week.
Well, that no picks is the key, as we've got a matchup today between two teams that started the week at numbers 8 and 9 in the league in terms of that takeaway giveaway ratio. Far too many giveaways to Ticats and Kerry Zeal in the early part of this season.
Hamilton's first possession, and Evans is passing, and he's passing deep. Stretched arms of Mike Jones in his first game back with Hamilton after playing the last two seasons with Edmonton. Jones nearly had a big reintroduction for the Ticats.
Yeah, Mike Jones, a guy who's best known for his speed, knows this offense, was brought in with some injuries to the Canadian receivers, particularly Tyler Tarnowski going down last game. Jones, as he's mentioned, a guy very familiar to Hamilton, a place where he started his career.
Drafted by the Ticats in 2016. He was born in Toronto. Second and 10, Hamilton 46. The pressure coming. He gets it away for Braylon Addison, who caught the ball. And they discussed, did he keep a foot in? And marking it as a catch for Braylon Addison. And a first down, Hamilton.
Yeah, and this one takes a little bit of an adjustment from Braylon Addison to slow down as he gets to the sidelines. Watch as it comes out of Dane Evans' hands. Ball is tipped a little bit, it looked like, from the rusher behind him, so it's fluttering. Takes a little bit longer to get there, but Addison adjusts nicely. Drags that back foot, right foot. Great concentration.
And a gain of 17. The 47, Toronto. Little screen to Addison, and lots of yardage after the catch for him. Down just around the 25 and another first down. Here come the Ticats on the move.
Well, a lot of talk when you look at the Toronto Argonauts and their free agent signings, as you see Braylon Addison starting off in the backfield alongside Dane Evans. You know, the Argos with Andrew Harris and Brandon Banks, you kind of think if they could channel 2019, things would be great for the Double Blue. Well, if they could channel 2019 for Braylon Addison, all good for the Cats.
A look into the end zone and a bit too far. The intended receiver, Lamar Durant, in his first year with the Cats, his second game, yet to catch a pass as a member of Hamilton.
Take a look at Hamilton's starting offense. Travis Barkholt continues to start at left tackle. Colin Kelly on the right side with Chris Van Zyl out of the lineup. And as mentioned, Mike Jones makes his 2022 Hamilton Tiger Cat debut. He and Lamar Durant, two Canadians in that starting receiving corps. Veteran group now.
Yeah, absolutely. Three receivers up to the right. Evans looks that way, and he finds Don Jackson down at the Argo 21. Well shy of a first down, setting up the field goal situation here for the Cats.
A good start for Hamilton, but second and long after that previous incompletion. Tough to overcome. Argos get the stop and force this field goal attempt.
For Seth Small, about a month on the job now for Hamilton. 4 for 5 overall. Longest coming from 30. This one, a little inside that, about 28 yards away for Small. Pops it between the uprights. 3 on the board for the Cats. The first quarter of the 4-game regular season series. Hamilton leads. said off the top, a scorching day in southern Ontario with more details on the heat. Let's go to Matthew Shinetti.
Well, it's a weather update first for you, Rob, because before kickoff in the sun, it's 36 degrees. I can tell you in the shade it feels better, but the air is very heavy. Now your hydration update. I spoke to both teams, your athletic staffs. Yes, there is salt packets. There are electrolytes. But critically, you have to, as a player, be ready for this game. Speaking to both staffs, 2 liters of water suggested for the players. They've been learning this since camp. If you're not hydrated, it will be a problem, guys.
Thank you, Matthew. With a play fake, and the Argos now to Marquise Hamilton. And he gets it up to the 45. And let's look at Hamilton's defense now.
Well, starting off with that defensive line, the veteran Micah Johnson, signed as a free agent, had his first 2 sacks in black and gold in last week's victory over Montreal. Much talk about the return of Simone Lawrence, first start for him since week 4. And Carriel Brooks, he made his 2022 debut last week in spectacular fashion. One of the league's interception leaders last year, had a pick.
On the 2nd and 5, completes it, first down, Argos across midfield. That's Cam Phillips, number 89, with the catch, his first of this day.
Cam Phillips is going to line up as your inside receiver in this set. Number 3 man in from the sideline. Quick stutter step working against nickel linebacker Cameron Kelly. Tough to cover for the linebacker in that situation, that quick out, as he's got to protect his inside first.
To the Hamilton 52 on the Phillips catch, back in the hands of Andrew Harris. Short carry, and his first one, his second one is much the same. Mason Bennett among the tie catch there to limit what Andrew Harris does on that play.
Well, as Matthew alluded to it just a minute ago, I mean, you talk about the hydration factor, and yeah, the point is, if you haven't looked after it before the game, guaranteed you're going to be in trouble during the game if you're trying to get hydrated as the game goes on.
Got to make sure Shinetti stays hydrated, too. Wearing that suit all game. He's a trooper. 2nd and 7. Bethel Thompson under the heat, and he has taken down. 3 tie cats were there in the blitz. Cameron Kelly, Simone Lawrence, and Dylan Wynn. And a big loss for the Argos, now facing 3rd down.
Well, this is like the turducken of sacks. This is Cameron Kelly, who you're going to see coming from the very top of your screen. He's on the blitz, but it's McLeod Bethel Thompson sacked by Cameron Kelly, sacked by Dylan Wynn, sacked by Simone Lawrence.
So Haggerty to punt for the 2nd time. Driving punt. And a catch out of bounds. And not all that far. It is inside the 25. The Ticats offense comes back on the field. Bethel Thompson under fire early here at BMO Field, and a 3-0 lead by Hamilton. The last meaningful game between the Argos and Ticats was the Eastern Final last December here at BMO, and Dane Evans came off in relief in the 2nd quarter of Jeremiah Masoli and proceeded to go 16 for 16 in Hamilton's victory to go to the Grey Cup.
Yeah, I mean, Dane Evans absolutely sparked that victory. A fantastic performance for him led to him starting the Grey Cup game a week later. A handful of big plays. You talk about a handful of plays turning the outcome of the game. Dave Evans made lots of them in that one.
Don Jackson is the ball carrier. You don't see Hamilton run the ball very much. Look at the Argonaut defense they're up against.
And defensively for Toronto, of course, all eyes tonight will be on the former Ticat, Garrett Davis, number 56, at defensive end. 19 sacks for him in black and gold over the last couple of years. Keep an eye on middle linebacker Enoch Mwamba, the same FX product. Deshaun Amos, former Chicago Stampede.
Evans gets away from the pressure. He gets rid of the ball, and he completes that pass up across the 40. It is Mike Jones for his first catch back as a member of the Tiger Cats, the team in the CFL he started with back in 2016.
Yeah, Mike Jones again. Familiar with the system, familiar with a lot of the personnel already in Hamilton, so pretty easy for him to slide back in the lineup on relatively short notice after rejoining his old team.
His last game with Hamilton was the 2019 Grey Cup in Calgary against Winnipeg. Schultz, the backup quarterback, they can do that now. Put two quarterbacks in on the offense. Schultz was a part of it last week, too, running the ball. Had a lot of reps at QB. And this time, taking it as a receiver for a gain of 20.
Yeah, and it's been interesting to watch how Hamilton has been able to use their two quarterbacks, whether on the field at the same time or switching on and off, getting the most out of both these guys. And a big part of it is letting Matthew Schultz, I think, outside of the perceived box that some people may have put him in.
Evans looking back the other way, but the pressure gets it away and it's nearly intercepted. His ex-teammate, Jagera Davis, who's been known to drop back in coverage, did it with the Ticats, nearly had an interception way downfield.
And Davis was able to anticipate this one coming, as you'll see Dane Evans scramble to his right, but he sets and looks back to his left right away. Davis back in coverage with Evans taking that hit as the ball is thrown. It kind of flutters and hangs up. I think that made it tough for Jagera to judge.
We've seen Jagera break up plays in the secondary before on this very field. Second and 10, Toronto 49. And that one is complete down inside the 40 once again to Mike Jones. And looks like it is just enough. It is for a Hamilton first down.
Yeah, credited with his furthest forward progress. And that'll move the sticks. You see Dane Evans once again navigating the pocket. Robbie Smith is in on him, forcing him to step up. It spots Jones right at that first down marker.
So a first and 10 at the Argo 39. Hamilton on the move now, leading by three. Braylon Addison, nowhere to go on that play. Wynton McManus coming in. I mentioned Jagera Davis as a Ticat. Remember this, Dwayne? Eastern final last year.
I sure do. One of the big plays in that game.
So this wasn't the Eastern final play, sorry, but a bunch of things he did as a Ticat.
Yeah, absolutely. Mentioned earlier, 19 sacks for him in black and gold in two seasons. And there is the big play with him dropping in coverage in that East final to prevent Toronto touchdown.
Covering ex-Argo running back DJ Foster there. Now with the Argos. Another first down, Braylon Addison. He's been busy, Jones has been busy. And Addison now still lying there after getting that first down on that catch. Hamilton already dealing with an injury to Sean Thomas Erlington, and now Braylon Addison is hurt.
Well, Addison, for those familiar with the Hamilton offensive system, you'll recognize this is an important guy because of his versatility. You worry a little bit as it looked like that leg gave out on him without contact. So hope it's not an Achilles.
We'll take a break and be back right after this.
Well, you see Braylon Addison make the catch here. He makes a couple moves, and before he's hit, that right leg appears to give out on him on that plant. You see him kind of holding the foot off the ground as he's going down, immediately grabbing at the right ankle area.
He had a terrific year complimenting Brandon Banks in 2019. One of the top receivers. We look at Keandre Smith, the rookie, might get a opportunity to come into this game, but Addison was injured through much of 2021 before training camp. Missed a lot of that season, and they were missing him. Did come back. But awful to see this after everything he did to get back into playing football last year.
just in terms of X's and O's, such an important guy for the Tiger Cats in their offense. We've seen him basically allow them to play what I'll call positionless football. We've seen him line up under center and take snaps in Wildcat formation. We've seen him line up as a running back, obviously lining up as a slot. So there are so many things you can do when you have Braylon Addison in your lineup. You lose a lot of personnel packages and formations when this guy goes down.
Orlando Steinauer back at the sideline. Braylon Addison still down and getting attention. Both medical staffs, Ticats and Argos, out to help. And mentioning what he did in 2019, complimenting the most outstanding player in the CFL that year, Brandon Banks, his old teammate. A terrific 1-2 punch, first for Jeremiah Masoli and then for Dane Evans, on the way to a 15-3 record and an appearance in the Grey Cup.
Make sure you guys stay loose.
And Steinauer heading back again to see how his player is doing. Two players very early were still in the first quarter, and
two players both on the offensive side of the ball as well. So again, impacting the game plan, impacting your depth. A hot day like this, you want to try and keep people fresh when you have the opportunity to do that. And now you're going to have some guys who are going to be able to occasionally get a blow who are going to be playing every snap.
There is Sean Thomas Erlington. He was injured on the opening kickoff. Smiles now. He was checked in the dressing room and appears to be fine and can go in again. And the cart coming out for Braylon Addison. Awful sight to see for a player, especially as mentioned, what he endured last year, played him only three games. In 2019, had 95 catches for 1,236 yards and 7 touchdowns.
And we've talked a lot about what Braylon Addison is as a player. This is a guy who is absolutely loved by his teammates. One of the absolute good guys of the Canadian Football League. That's regardless of what team you cheer for, heartbreaking to see him leaving the
field.
Absolutely. Like this.
We talked to him last year about everything that he endured to get back with the Ticats. And had several touches in this game, a key part of Hamilton's offense, with well wishes from his Ticat teammates as he is taken off.
As you see, literally every player on that Ticat team come over to give their support to Braylon Addison.
Pain that goes beyond the physical, to be sure. They're about to resume this game. 4:38 and counting on a first and 10. Hamilton with the ball on the Toronto 25 and a three-point lead. Straight up, Don Jackson, big running play, and Hamilton hasn't had a lot of those inside the 10 and a first and goal for the Tiger Cats.
Oh, Don Jackson with a burst that suggests he's tired of seeing Schultz and Evans 1-2 atop the Ticats' leading rushers board. Watch the work of the offensive line here, double team. Rivenberg up to second level.
Jackson again, this time not much doing as he is pushed back by Robbie Smith for a short gain. He'll be second and goal. The ball right at the 9.
Sean Thomas Erlington checking into the game right now. Be a two-back set with he and Don Jackson in the game together. Thomas Erlington comes in with a Z receiver, wide side, wide out.
And this will be the 10th play of the drive.
Timeout, Hamilton.
As they were setting up.
Yeah. Now they were at risk of a time count violation there. As the substitution came late and with the benches on the same side, that's a long run in for Thomas Erlington from the Hamilton bench with the Ticats deep in Argo territories. They weren't going to get the playoff there. Good clock awareness from Dane Evans to call time.
Looking to find the end zone for the first time for either team on the second down. Evans eludes the rush, bends it off, and a touchdown, Don Jackson. Second straight game, Jackson's picked up a touchdown.
A celebration reminiscent of a young Rod Smith.
Yeah. Except mine was not intentional.
You were just trying to get up. Jackson starting in the backfield here. Little chip on the defensive end, then check release. Dane Evans goes to his check down. The Ticats, despite the early adversity, have the game's first touchdown.
The point after try by Seth Small. Don Jackson had not gone over 100 yards yet this season in rushing. He did that earlier in the drive, and then receiving adds to his touchdown total, and that's a pretty nice dance, too.
Yeah, let's redo the basement.
Down drive there for the Hamilton Ticats. Costly one, but as they lose Braylon Addison along the way, but Matthew Schultz with a big reception. Along the way, Mike Jones in his first game back with the Cats chipping in. Don Jackson on the ground. Don Jackson through the air for the major.
And a 10-0 lead. Jackson now has 2 touchdowns on the season. So Michael Domagala will kick this one off for Hamilton at the Ticat 30. Back for it, along with Curly Gittens, is the rookie, number 21, Daniel Adetoboye. Goes to Gittens inside the 10. Not a lot of love for the Ticats in Argo land, with one notable and understandable exception. Number 16. Let's go back to Matthew.
Very quick shout out. A lot of love to Jermaine Franklin for being on the sidelines last week. Well, back in February, when Brandon Banks signed with the Argos, he got a swag box. And his son, Brandon Jr., who, by the way, used to run around Tim Hortons Field wearing a Ticats jersey quite happily, took out an Argos hat, put it on, and Brandon Banks said, "This move is real weird." But he says, "Now I feel like an Argo." He spoke to the team this week and said, "You know what, guys? Every moment matters. We have to beat the Ticats."
Thanks, Matthew, and glad to see you back. And yes, kudos to Jermaine as well. But Brandon Banks, before the game, and meets up with some ex-teammates and lots to talk about, I'm sure. And he thinks it's weird. I think it's weird for a lot of football fans to see Speedy B in double blue.
Yeah, well, no question. As given the heat that exists in that rivalry, changing sides can't be easy.
Second and 10 after that one was deflected. And that time just gets thrown into the turf as Cameron Kelly was in taking Bethel Thompson down just as he was getting rid of the football. So more heat from that Ticat defense and some boos raining down here for that Argo offense as they go 2 and out, third down.
Cameron Kelly, such an impact guy. You're going to see him coming once again from the right side of your screen. Unblocked man arriving just as the ball is thrown to disrupt that one. But this guy is a difference maker. kind of your prototype at that nickel position, making great plays in coverage, great plays up against the run, great plays as a blitzer.
Better punt by John Haggerty inside the 30 for Lawrence Woods, who gets it out to about the 35 before he is pushed out of bounds. Last time the Ticats had the ball, yes, they lost Braylon Addison, a big concern. They were able to get into the end zone and now lead it 10-0. Dane Evans has started 8 for 11, 108 yards in that touchdown pass.
It'll be interesting to keep an eye, Rod, as this game unfolds on some of the things Hamilton does in terms of personnel packages. We mentioned Braylon Addison's a guy who does a lot of different things for you offensively. They'll have to be by committee to sort of fill his multiple roles in this offense.
From the Ticats 35, play fake to Jackson. Looking downfield, over the middle, complete, up near midfield. That is caught by Stephen Dunbar, one of the leaders in touchdown catches this year, with 5 so far.
Here you'll see off play action to Don Jackson. Pretty good protection and a strike. Dunbar making the tough catch, as he has been known to do.
The top receiver for the Cats, coming in with 30 catches, 488 yards. Second to Dalton Schoen in touchdown catches, and now the Argos with an injury concern. The boundary half, Shaquille Richardson limping off for Toronto. The net yard difference, 149 for Hamilton, just 16 for the Argos. The Ticats have the ball in that 10-point lead. As we get close to the end, the final minute of quarter number one. Up near midfield, at the Ticats 53, Evans. Making the toss, throwing it back to Jackson. Has some room. It's taken down by Robert Priester, but not before he gets another first down. Just around the 45 of Toronto.
And Priester had checked into the game at the boundary halfback spot in place of the injured Shaq Richardson. He was coming on the blitz and had to redirect here as he saw Jackson slipping out to catch that screen. Grab for the Ticat running back. That'll earn him a break as Sean Thomas Erlington comes on to spell him.
From the Argo 46, handing off for Thomas Erlington. A nice move by Sean Thomas Erlington to move the sticks again inside the Argo 35.
And he looks like he's overcome the effects of a collision with teammate Grant McDonald on the game's opening kickoff. Nice hard cut there, lowering the shoulder, running through contact. Certainly no worse for wear.
This will be the last play of the first quarter. In what is the first quarter of the regular season series, game 1 of 4 over the next 5 weeks between these two Southern Ontario rivals. From the Argo 34, throwing again and completing. That one is caught by Keandre Smith, his second career catch. Had one last week against the Montreal Alouettes. So that is quarter time. And Hamilton visiting BMO, in control of the Argos so far in this game, despite their injuries. And a big one to Braylon Addison. Don Jackson with the touchdown. 10-0 to score through 15.
This
through one quarter, it's the type of score that is completely in line with the stats, Dwayne, so far. Hamilton dominance, especially when you look at the net yards, 181 to 16 only for Toronto.
Yeah, the Argos held to a couple of possessions in that first quarter, two and outs. And that's something that the Ticats have done particularly well, leading the league in forcing those situations. Toronto's got to find a way, obviously, to even out that time of possession and obviously even out the scoreboard.
And they've been in Hamilton's defense doing a great job of putting the heat on McLeod Bethel-Thompson.
Yeah, they certainly have, finding different ways to get to him. We've seen Cameron Kelly in that backfield a couple of times as they seem to be missing that nickel linebacker in terms of their blitz pickup.
And versatile, too, on offense so far. The number of receivers that have been used by Dane Evans, including his own backup quarterback, Matthew Schultz, with a catch in a 20-yard gain. So the second quarter begins with Dane Evans and a first down.
A There's Hamilton offensive coordinator Tommy Condell. Man of a million formations.
That's the direct snap to Schiltz. Evans was right there. Schiltz actually faked a handoff to Evans. So using the two quarterback system again, Tommy Condell is on the field together. The last time, as mentioned, Evans threw a pass to Schiltz that gained 20 yards in the first quarter.
And we talked a little bit actually prior to their last game about this formation. Dane Evans is going to come from the slot. They fake the handoff to him. We've seen him a couple of times in this look. Receive the ball coming to his right and throwing it as he's going to his right, going to his strong side. That time Schiltz keeping it to go behind the two pulling linemen.
Evans back at quarterback. Takes a look to the end zone, and Dunbar turned around, not quite there. The coverage was good by the Argos, so it sets up a third down. And still a chance for the Ticats to add more points. Jamal Peters there on Dunbar.
Yeah, that should be a great battle to watch all night. Dunbar and Peters, two terrific players, both with some length, some range, very well matched.
Seth Small attempting his second field goal. He hit one from 28. This one from 28 as well. And it's hugging that left upright, but hugging it on the inside. Three more on the board. Quiet day so far again for Andrew Harris, who has two carries for 5 yards, and his team is now trailing by 13 in Toronto.
Now's the time.
Doubleheader Saturday. CFL on TSN keeps rolling tonight. It's the Elks and the Lions. They meet again in Vancouver. Action beginning right after this one. Around 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific. Only here on TSN. Kenny Lawler, Lucky Whitehead, two great receivers.
Elks going to be with a little revenge on their mind after the one-sided week one beatdown. BC winning that one 59-15.
The Argos trailing 13-0, and Andrew Harris is having trouble for the second straight game getting anything going at all in that running game.
The Argos have alternated back and forth this season between, as a team, rushing for over 100 and failing to get over 100 on the ground. If the pattern holds true, it should be a strong night for Harris in the run game tonight, but the Ticats suggesting they'll have something to say about that.
Nothing at all for Harris on that carry. Toronto 40, second and 10. Bethel Thompson to his left. He completes that one for a first down. Tavares Daniels back in the Argo lineup with the catch.
First down for the Toronto Argonauts, just into Hamilton territory. 54-yard line. See Daniels standing to catch that.
There you go. Back to Harris. Has yardage this time. Not first down yardage, but close. He picks up about 8 yards, and easily the best carry for Andrew Harris in a couple of games.
Yeah, they go quads into the boundary here, taking a lot of the Hamilton defenders over to the short side of the field, then run back to the wide side, creating a great opportunity for Andrew Harris to bounce that one wide, which he does. A nice pickup.
Pickup of 8, second and 2, Hamilton 46. And it looks like he has the 2, but not much more as they push him back afterwards with the whistles blowing.
Simone Lawrence in his return to action at his familiar weak side linebacker position. Not surprising to see him sticking his nose in there.
Back for the first time in a month and injured in the game against Edmonton. Back in week 4. So Bethel Thompson off to his right. Gittens with it inside the 40. Curley Gittens. And on that first down play, another good gain on first down for the Argos. It'll be second and short.
Well, the Toronto Argonauts leading receiver, burgeoning star Curley Gittens, catches the hitch there for a nice pickup.
Rotating receivers, Banks, Eric Rogers come out, Tavares Daniels comes in, along with Gittens and Marquise Ambles and Cam Phillips on the second down and short. To Andrew Harris, and he is met, and he is stuffed for nothing. Micah Johnson comes in and takes Harris down, and it'll be third down.
Well, Micah Johnson dominating at the line of scrimmage here, lines up just shading the center slightly. Quick swim on him. They're trying to get the guard onto him, but Micah Johnson is into the backfield before the guard can get over a gap to get on him.
And so John Haggerty, the holder, will put it down for Boris Beatty. Just shy of a 44-yard try for Beatty. He was 2 for 2, longest 42 last week. And Beatty gets the Argos on the board. But it was Micah Johnson saying this is the end of the drive right there with that tackle and Andrew Harris. Ticats up by 10. Stephen Dunbar, not only the Ticats top receiver, one of the best in the CFL, not by accident, Matthew.
Not at all, Rod. I went ahead and I spoke to Alden Darby, who is a healthy scratch tonight, because I wanted a defender's perspective on the man who Orlando Steinauer and some of the coaches' staff say in Hamilton is the guy that everyone should be practicing like. And Darby said to me the way that Stephen Dunbar has evolved as a receiver in his second season, he understands how to use the field, how to understand coverages around him. And then I went to Stephen Dunbar, who apparently gets to Tim Hortons Field at 6 a.m. and uses the jug machine over 4 hours a week. And he said, this is compound interest. This is work, and these are the results. Guys?
Results showing very well this season, Matthew. Stephen Dunbar, 5 touchdown catches. Quickly, it's to Tim White. First touch of the game for White across the 45 for Hamilton. Remember this a few weeks ago? Tim Hortons Field in Hamilton against the Ottawa Redblacks.
Well, it remains a candidate for catch of the year. Stephen Dunbar with the twisting one-handed stab here against the Calgary Stampeders.
Well, as you said at the time, the flag came out for interference. He didn't need the help of the flag. 13-3 Hamilton with the ball and an open receiver, but not close enough to Mike Jones there, so it'll be third down and 4, and the Ticats will have to punt it away.
And again, yeah, Matthew Schultz getting a series at quarterback there, and this is typically what we've seen, kind of late first quarter, second quarter, early second quarter. Schultz getting involved in the offense a little bit, he and Dane Evans having some success working in tandem here with the Ticats.
And Brandon Banks is back for the punt return. Something he mastered years ago with the Ticats, taking this from Domagal as he stands inside the 20. Speedy D with the ball. And nowhere to run. Great coverage by the special teams, Stavros Katsantonis, but Brandon Banks, dominant returner in his early years when he came over to Hamilton in 2013. In 2017, June Jones took over as coach, made him a receiver again, and he took off in that department as well.
Yeah, he certainly did. June Jones, of course, best known for run-and-shoot type offense, an offense in which typically smaller, quick receivers have had a lot of success historically. And he took a look at the speed and explosiveness of Brandon Banks and said, this is a guy we need to have on the field more than just special team situations, and the rest is history.
He remembered that moment in his career very well, significant as he was. Bethel Thompson Pete. Oh, nearly intercepted there. Richard Leonard coming in on Banks. his old teammate to help break that one up.
Well, Brandon Banks demonstrates on this one. He's still got some wheels. Will play action to help buy time, help out the protection. Looking down the seam for Banks, but Leonard, the halfback, ranging out to help out his corner, Ciante Evans, on the play.
He knows those guys well from practice. He can be sure over the years. Leonard, a teammate of his before he went to Calgary and then coming back to Hamilton last year. Heat's on. Dylan Wynn's got him. Down goes Bethel Thompson. Dylan Wynn adding to his sack total. That's number four this season.
Yeah, you'll see number 98 tucked in behind there, lining up on the outside in this 30 front. Julian Hauser occupies a couple on the inside, creating a little bit of space for Mr. Wynn to go to work. Grey Cup ring as a member of the Toronto Argonauts. 2017.
Great punt by Haggerty. Woods chased back to his 30. And Enoch Penny-Laye finally the one to take Woods down up across the 40. Dylan Wynn knows the rivalry from both sides like Brandon Banks does. Ex-Argo, big sack for the Ticats and a 10-point lead.
Furniture legs can scar your floors, costing you a...
Sitting down and done for the day. He's in a boot cast, a walking boot, and got the crutches with him as well. And an injury that happened in the first quarter after he played only three games because of leg injuries in 2021. Down Hamilton. Pickup of 11 yards, Jackson.
The Hamilton offensive line continuing to do a good job in the run game, creating another nice seam here for Don Jackson. Double team center and left guard. Great blocks, and then center. Alex Fontana up to second level to take out the middle linebacker.
Terrific line work. Jackson now with three rushes for 22 yards. May not sound like much, but that's ahead of the rushing pace the Ticats have had for much of this season. They've been throwing a lot, throwing here, but not close to the intended receiver, Tim White. So it'll be second down.
Ticats continue to shuffle personnel. Sixth offensive lineman out of the game. Fullback Jake Burton in. See Toronto defensive coordinator Corey Mace. Trying to keep pace with those personnel changes, making sure he's got the right people on in response.
Robert Priester in. The boundary half of the injured Shaq Richardson, second and 10, Hamilton 54. That one is complete. Coming back, turning around, Mike Jones. And inside the Toronto 50 is still about 3 yards shy of a first down. And he's hurt now.
Yeah, Jones taking a pretty good hit. Weak side linebacker Winton McManus gets a pretty good piece of him right around the ribs or the hip. Enoch Mwamba with a little tug on the helmet in the pile up there. McManus has quickly established himself as one of the Argos' defensive leaders this season, but the costly penalty in the loss last week. Little over exuberant celebration. Yeah, throwing William Powell's shoe after making a tackle.
And on that play on Powell, for Ryan Dinwiddie, they had held them to a field goal, what would have been a field goal try, and a six-point lead. Instead, that McManus penalty led to an Ottawa touchdown and a two-score lead in the Red Blacks. One victory this season. Now, that said, McManus, you see Mike Jones heading off. Now, McManus has been the hero, too. Touchdown Atlantic a few weeks ago, trailing by two, intercepted Cody Fajardo and took it to the house as the Argos came back and won that game. And you're right, he's been one of their best on their defense this year. So Brandon Banks standing back to receive this punt from Michael Domagala. From his 50. Wobbles down and off the hop. Banks takes it at the 15. And he is greeted. Strange feeling for Brandon Banks, but certainly no hard feelings to an organization he still cares about a lot. Here's what he had to say about facing the Cats.
I got to give all credit to Hamilton and Ticats. They made me who I am today. I mean, I went through a lot. I went through a lot in the last 9 years, emotionally, physically, everything off the field. I'm just honored to be who I am, because to be honest, if you asked me who I would be 10 years ago, I didn't think I'd be the man I am today.
You don't often hear an Argo talking about the Ticats that way, but under these circumstances, very understandable. Trails his old team right now. Andrew Harris has it in his hands. Gets it up to the 25, make it at the 26-yard line, and a second and five coming up.
And we think of Andrew Harris so much as kind of a between-the-tackles runner, but we've seen him find a little bit of success tonight getting to the outside against Hamilton. We'll see if that trend continues or if they manage to sort of soften Hamilton up on the outside to open up a little bit of room in those A-B gaps.
Big free agent acquisitions by the Argos, who've gone against each other in the last two Grey Cups in Harrison Banks. Bethel Thompson tries to get rid of it. For all sorts of heat, he has finally taken down Ted Laurent among those right in the middle. Big Ted Laurent gets the sack, and that is his first of the season.
Yeah, the big man in slightly reduced role this season. They've formed that kind of inside three-man rotation with Laurent, Dylan Wynn, of course, and Micah Johnson. So Ted not playing as many snaps, but I think that could be bad news for opponents to have to deal with that guy with fresh legs.
3 minute warning coming up here for halftime. Lawrence Woods with it. Big return, Lawrence Woods across midfield. They said he was questionable for health reasons to play in this game, but has a nice return there for the Hamilton Tiger Cats with the ball and with the lead. 3 minutes to head into the dressing room.
Thanks, man. Chez is going to talk about the Argos O-line. And speaking of Chez, last year he went the whole day without telling us that it was his birthday. So this birthday. Are you 84?
48.
Happy birthday to you, Chez.
Don't do it. Don't do it. I got three girlfriends.
Happy birthday to you. Are you going to sing?
Davis Sanchez.
Chez told me he was only 29.
He's been 29 for several years now, actually. Happy birthday, Chezzy. Don Jackson inside the 50. And down to the 45 is the Ticats. Good opportunity to add to their 10-point lead before halftime.
Well, we'll get the two quarterback look here. A little bit of confusion on the Ticats sidelines. Ultimately, Schultz back to the sidelines. Sean Thomas Erlington into the game. Big second down here.
A second and four. Evans off to his left and just throws it away. And for the first time in this game, a flag comes out. Closest receiver, Stephen Dunbar.
Holding Hamilton, number 50. That penalty is declined. Third down.
Not much use of the mic for Andre Preux so far in this game as he makes that announcement. The first penalty and a holding call against the Cats. So Domagala will come out to punt it. And Banks going back.
A big opportunity here for the Toronto Argonauts to try to cut this to a one possession game before the break. Brandon Banks counting on the short side punt here. He gets it.
Deep punt, Domagala into the end zone and out. So the Argos will get to start at their 40. That's not what Hamilton wanted. They get a point for it to make it 14-3. Curley Gittens coming on. Look at the receiving yards for Canadians this season, and he's leading the way at 448.
Yeah, really picking up right where he left off. 2021, Curley Gittens is something of a breakout season last year. The Toronto Argonauts leader. And as you just saw, leader among all Canadian receivers thus far.
So from the 40, after that punt, and there's Eric Rogers' first catch of the season for the Argos. The last time he played was in the Eastern Final for Toronto back last December.
Yeah, two-time 1,000-yard receiver during his time with the Calgary Stampeders. Had a couple of very dominant seasons in red and white. On the topic of the Stampeders, by the way, got to give a shout out to my guy, George Hopkins.
Geo.
Yes, sir.
1,000.
Longtime Stampeders equipment manager with his 1,000th CFL game last night in Ottawa.
That's just, it's incredible when you think about it, how far back he goes.
Yeah, started when he was a kid.
George Hopkins, our congratulations too, and a marvelous career in the Canadian Football League, and the Stamps gave him a victory too in Ottawa last night. Gave him the game ball, I understand, afterwards too.
He's earned more than a few of those over the years.
Just across midfield now after Eric Rogers' first catch. Another completion. And that's the Rogers again. 1:35 on the clock.
Well, we're getting finally the rivalry heating up a little bit. I was hoping nobody was going to wait until Labor Day to get ticked off at each other.
I was going to say Labor Day is the last of the four over the next month instead of the first, as we've often seen when these two teams meet. That's Markeith Ambles and a first down. Argos on the move late, so they started at their 40 after the punt single by Domagala, who wanted to hem them deep. And Toronto certainly has time to add to their three-point total before halftime. Tough first half for this offense. Bethel Thompson to his left, wide open and complete. That's Tavares Daniels, another first down inside the 30.
Just going back to that Hamilton punt. Right now proving to be a costly miss for the Hamilton Tiger Cats as they were punting for field position, trying to hem the Argos deep. Instead, what is at this point in the game a relatively meaningless single. That may obviously change depending on how things play out, but that single and the accompanying field position to start the drive give the Argos quite a boost here.
Second catch, Daniels now has 32 yards in the game. The Hamilton 27 now, first down. And that's inside the 25. It is caught by Andrew Harris. Down as he catches the ball. Second down coming up. And still plenty of time. 1:12 until halftime.
McLeod Bethel Thompson seeming to find his groove a little bit on this drive.
Second and six. Oh, Rogers inside the 10 and had it, and it went out. And a big break for the Ticats there because it would have been at least first and goal for Toronto, maybe worse.
And a rare drop to the veteran Eric Rogers. Normally sure-handed.
And instead, they'll settle for the field goal try. Carriel Brooks was bearing down on Rogers. Couldn't hang on to the football. Boris Beattie. One for one in the night. This exactly 30 yards away. And it's perfect. So he's two for two. And they get it to within 8 points. Just under a minute until halftime. And at the half, we will hear from Kate Burness, Matt Dunnigan, Milt Stegall, and the birthday boy, Davis Sanchez. The flag has come out. There they are. You don't look a day older, Chez. Saw him and Milton, Dave Naylor, with hair last night. I don't know if you saw that. Halftime promo.
I actually missed them.
There are 2,000 to play. Objectionable conduct. Toronto number 44. Major fouls. Unnecessary roughness. Hamilton number 11. Both fouls are misconduct. We're going to go up 5 yards on the kickoff.
Brandon Calver for Toronto. Cameron Kelly.
We're going to go back. We're going to go back five.
You come to expect something from these two teams. This was Labor Day, their first meeting of 2021 last year, as the game was over and Hamilton was about to celebrate a win, and then this happened.
Yeah, just trying to get some kneel downs. Things heat up a little bit.
Never seen that before between the Argos and Ticats. Shocking, isn't it? Well, especially, I mean, and a concern all season long for the Argos, especially the extracurriculars. Don Jackson on the ground, under a minute to go. But you do wonder, honestly, with all the bad blood that these organizations normally have, this is the first of 4 in 5 weeks.
Yeah, rather peculiar situation.
There it is. That was last year. They didn't start until that Labor Day game. That was game one. And then Toronto won the remaining 3 regular season games and were leading 12-0 at the half in the Eastern Final before the Tiger Cats came back. And they won it 27-19, and they went on to host the Grey Cup against Winnipeg. Quite a history over the years between these two. Just getting started in 2022. Not even halfway through game one of 4 in the regular season. That's Dunbar. 27 seconds to go. And a third down coming up here.
Jamal Peters with a nice tackle in space there. Staying right with Dunbar off the juke.
And you consider the state of the East right now, with Montreal losing, with Ottawa losing again. And these two teams, the possibility of a crossover from the West, that only two teams would make it in the East. How important are these four between the Argos and Ticats?
Well, it's like we've got a little bit of an NHL-style four-game playoff series happening right here in the middle of the season.
Letting that play clock run right now. The punt by Domagal as it rolls out of bounds. And that looks like the last play of the first half. They are indeed calling it for McLeod Bethel Thompson, 9 of 14, 89 yards. It's been tough for that Argo offense. 14-3, Ticats lead it. Let's go back to the studio and Kate Burness.
80 proof, getting my first taste of gone.
Tell me that.
Yeah, we were just debating. It's gone. The word is gone,
I
Matt.
Thank you. I figured that out last
You're
night.
You're very welcome.
Maddie, hey, dialing in, bro.
Let's get to some stats.
Let's dial these stats in. The 58-yard rushing for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, yes, that's what they need to do. The sacks for their D-line and Dylan Wynn, that guy's eating. He was jacked up before the game, and he's jacked up with his interview, too, with Schnetty on the sidelines.
Roll silver.
Now, Dylan, most people don't know that this week I asked you all of the responsibilities that you might have on defense, and you said, listen, I just got to do my 1-12. You've held them to 6 points. How has everyone's 1-12 been so far this half? 3 sacks for the defensive line.
It's great. Job's not finished. Game's not done. Job's not finished. We got to go.
Things are tightening up. How do you keep them in the pocket, keep a Clyde Bethel-Thompson in the pocket, and Andrew Harrison stop them?
It's just our jobs. Chop wood. That's it.
Thanks, Dylan.
Appreciate you.
Oh, my God.
He forgot carry water. You gotta say chop wood.
I would be hanging out with Dylan when I'm on that team. I'm telling you right now.
He had to use the bathroom.
That guy.
I gotta go.
He's on point, Bill.
We gotta go.
He's on what?
Beautiful. He's on point.
He's on point.
He's on point.
I know what she is going to say.
I never
field in Toronto getting set for the start of the second half. The Ticats leading the Argos 14-6. And let's go to Matthew Schenetti with Jagarrad Davis.
Jagarrad, what kind of adjustments were you making to at least put a cap on their offense a little bit towards the end of that first half?
The first thing, we just need to run from the box. I mean, they're doing a lot of misdirection, just getting guys out of leverage, and we just got to do better for rally as a team. Stop their runs to a minimum, tackle the first time, and just get out the box, make their second and long, make them second 6-8 instead of second 2-4.
And we've seen Coach Mace be creative, and you in coverage, do you like sometimes pulling back a little bit?
Whatever it helps to make the team win. If I got to drop back a little bit more, so be it.
Thanks, Jagarrad.
No problem.
We talked a lot about Brandon Banks, but Jagarrad Davis, look at defensive coordinator Corey Mace of the Argos. Davis, well, he was with Mace in Calgary before he went to the Ticats in 19, there again in 2021. So for Jagarrad Davis, too, strange feeling going up against his old team for the first time since signing with Toronto.
Yeah, he talked to us a lot about that relationship with Corey Mace and the role that that played in his decision to move over to the Toronto Argonauts. Said during their time together in Calgary, Corey Mace was like a big brother to him. And when Jagarrad was a rookie in the league, Corey Mace was essentially a rookie coach. They were both kind of finding their way. Their personalities clicked very well, and both found success. We'll reconnect here in Toronto.
Second half getting underway off the foot of Boris Beattie and into the hands of Lawrence Woods at the 20. Ticats lead to start quarter number three as Woods gets it across the 30-yard line for Dane Evans coming on. 12 for 18, 154 yards, and one touchdown pass to Don Jackson.
Yeah, Dane Evans with a solid start this ball game, spreading the ball around to a number of different receivers despite dealing with some bumps and bruises and more in that receiving core. And as the guys talked about at halftime, certainly a big help for Dane Evans that they've got that running game going a little bit.
Whistle blows and a flag comes out with the snap of the football.
Procedure, Hamilton number 50, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
That's the left tackle Travis Vaughn call, but Dwayne, you talked about the different receivers, 7 in all, including Braylon Addison, who was the most productive, 3 catches, 52 yards before really unfortunately got hurt. And was just watching from the sidelines now. That's so tough to see. And another receiver was Matthew Schultz, the backup quarterback, and this one is in the hands of Stephen Dunbar. And not much doing there, and a flag comes out again.
Offside, Hamilton, number 3. That penalty is declined. Second down.
Well, Jake Burt, usually fullback or tight end. See how close he is. He's at about the 29-yard line. Ball's at like the 26 and a half. You know, as a former fullback, I want to say, though, you know, I don't think a 2.5-yard head start is unreasonable.
Take whatever edge you can get. He didn't get that edge that time, so lining up offside, and they get pushed back 5 yards on the second down. And it's swung out to Don Jackson, who's a touchdown in this game. Gets it up across the 45. That's a first down on that second and long. Executed nicely by the Tiger Cat offense.
Yeah, great. great blocks by the two receivers out wide. I believe it was Tim White and Stephen Dunbar leading the way. Watch out. Look at the gap that the two of them have created. One blocking, Dunbar blocking out, White blocking in. Nice lane in between for Don Jackson to go to work as he continues his very productive night.
Up to the Hamilton 49. First possession, second half. Handing off to Jackson this time. Stopped after 2 or 3 yards, but he keeps driving and gets it up to about the 54. And a gain of 5 there for the Ticats.
And a commitment to the, what I'd call the more traditional run game tonight for the Hamilton Ticats. Don Jackson pounding that ball up between the tackles.
He has 11 touches for 90 yards. On the ground, though, 7 carries for 46, longest of 16. Near midfield on the 2nd and 5. Completed a first down and more. And that's Keandre Smith, whose father, Adrian Smith, was a...
would know both sides of this rivalry, having started his career with a season in Hamilton, made a stop in Memphis before finding his way to Toronto, where he was certainly best known.
Adrian Smith, here in Hamilton, the Grey Cup in 96, intercepted Danny McManus, then of Edmonton, for a touchdown for Toronto in their Grey Cup win over 25 years ago. So after the Keandre Smith pass, you're looking at Lamar Durant. First reception as a Ticat.
Yeah, Durant came off the 6-game injured list, made his Tiger Cat debut last week against Montreal. Had a quiet night in that one. I'm not sure if he was necessarily at 100% yet, but this is a guy who I think could be a big difference maker for Hamilton as this season unfolds.
Had some great years in Calgary and a couple of great years with the BC Lions, too. With individual stats that carry by Jackson, Lamar Durant, his best year statistically in 2019, when he caught 57 for over 800 yards and 5 touchdowns. And signing on as a free agent this offseason, but because he was hurt, he couldn't start playing until last week against the Alouettes.
Durant, an absolute steal as the number 18 overall pick back in 2015.
Dane Evans in the short yardage, keeps it himself to get the first down. They are inside the Argo 30. Good start for this Tiger Cat offense coming into the half with an 8-point lead.
Sean Thomas Erlington into the game as Don Jackson gets to catch his breath. Keep him fresh. We heard from Matthew Schinetti about the importance of that hydration as well here on a high humidity evening.
Evans to pass on first down completion. Another first down. Keandre Smith again had his first CFL catch last week, and he is having a busier night tonight as he picks up more catches here. That's his third of the night.
Yeah, Keandre, the 37th overall pick, fourth rounder in this year's draft out of the University of Guelph, where they're starting a pretty good tradition of producing receivers. Coach Ryan Shahan's team, of course, Keon Schaefer Baker, the poster boy. Keandre Smith, keep an eye on next year's draft on a real up-and-comer in Clark Barnes.
10th play of the drive, and a look to the end zone for Evans, looking for Dunbar and too far. It was Tavares McFadden, the field corner, on the coverage there of Dunbar.
We'll see what Tommy Condell is able to dial up for his quarterback, Dane Evans, here. One possession ball game, critical offensive green zone possession here for the Tiger Cats. Looking to come away with more than 3.
That change they had to make in the Argo secondary. Shaq Richardson, we are told. Matthew Stenny tells us that he will not be back in this game. Robert Priestman is in. Look to the end zone. No, it's broken up. Close there. Winton McManus back in coverage of Dunbar to force a third down and a field goal try coming up here for the Ticats.
Once again, just demonstrating the range of so many of your CFL linebackers. So that ball actually slipped through. I think Dunbar was probably late picking it up. The big body of McManus between him and his quarterback.
Had a chance at touchdown number 6 on the season, but not quite. Falling incomplete. So here is Seth Small, 2 for 2, both from 28. This one a little shorter. But 22 yards away, 3 for 3. Seth Small. Three more on the board. Brandon Banks' old team leading his current one. Now 17-6. Argo football, third quarter.
Now's the time to leave.
Well, busy night for the Hamilton Tiger Cats defensive line getting after Toronto's quarterback, McLeod Bethel Thompson. All sorts of heat coming from that black and gold front. I think Dylan Wynn would suggest so far they've done a pretty good job of chopping wood.
As he told Matthew Shinetti, got to get back and chop wood. Time for Bethel Thompson, wide open receiver. Play of the night for the Argos, and it has set them up near the Hamilton 20 in a first down to run.
Well, looks like a busted coverage here, and you'll see the moment where McLeod Bethel Thompson recognizes no one's going with Cam. Right down the seam, and Richard Leonard recognizing it late. In chase mode once that ball is in the air, but I suspect some signals crossed in the Hamilton secondary on that one.
A gain of 49, the previous best of the night for Toronto was 16. Handing off, Andrew Harris inside the 20, inside the 15. Tripped up and taken down, but not before a gain of about 8 yards. It'll be a second and short coming up here for Toronto.
I'll take a look back at that big game. There you see the free safety, Tunde Adeleke. He's about 10 yards off the line of scrimmage. He jumps that short route, leaving him with not a lot of help deep. Stan Phillips heads down that seam.
The fullback Declan Cross coming in, and that backfield with Andrew Harris taking the handoff. Bethel Thompson chased by Mason Bennett. He gets rid of it! Touchdown, Argo!
McLeod Bethel Thompson was done in the backfield. Watch for Mason Bennett, number 90, the front side end. Gets hands on him, but Bethel Thompson, a guy not necessarily known for his elusiveness, makes a nice move to spin back to the inside there and finds Cam Phillips sitting down just over that goal line. Great play there from the Argo quarterback.
Three plays, 70 yards in just over a minute and a half. The Argos strike back and they'll go for two. 5-point game right now, seeing if they can get it to a 3-point game on this 2-point try. Into the hands of Andrew Harris. Two more points on the board for Toronto, and we've got a 3-point game. Struggling through much of this game. But a long pass to Cam Phillips. And then this to Phillips again. 17-14. Hamilton still in front.
Finished? Of course not.
Well, it looks like the original plan on that touchdown play has Cam Phillips working towards the corner of the end zone while quarterback McLeod Bethel-Thompson rolls to his right. But when Bethel-Thompson goes back to the inside, Phillips fights back inside on scramble. The man in coverage, Jamal Roll, is still thinking corner. He gets caught out wide as his receiver slips back to the middle for the touchdown.
It had been a quieter night for Phillips, but suddenly in one drive, two catches. He now has three on the night for 75 yards and a touchdown. And that was his third touchdown of the season in his second year from Virginia Tech. Cam Phillips. Argos down, only a field goal, and kicking off now. So the Ticats feeling the momentum swing here in Toronto. Lawrence Woods gets hit hard on that coverage. Jack Kassar coming down on that kick coverage. Argo team fired up. Hamilton football with Phillips in the Argo offense. Tighten up this game, the first of four in the next month between these two. The epic prequel to the groundbreaking Game of Thrones, House of the Dragon, an HBO original series streaming Sunday, August 21st, and you can only watch it on Crave. Back here at BMO Field in Toronto, is set the first of four meetings in 5 weeks between the Argos and the Ticats. Lots of time to get to know one another a little bit better, as if they didn't already. And we got a tighter game now. Hamilton football leading only by three. Sean Thomas Ehrlichman. He gets around and he takes that ball down to the 29, a gain of five for the Ticats.
A nice read there by Thomas Ehrlichman to bounce it to the outside. Pretty good collision there. The Ticat running back banging into three Argo defenders.
Just shy of the 30. See how Hamilton responds now. After that momentum swinging touchdown drive, a quick one by the Argos. Shane Ray coming in. Evans gets it away to Dunbar. First down and more. Up across the 35 for the Ticats.
A big drive for the Hamilton Tiger Cats here, Rod, as I think it's so important for them, a team that has had their issues in the second half of football games, trying to hold on to leads. As Toronto has a little bit of momentum, Ticats need to put an end to that right here.
The Dunbar catch, his fourth for 29 yards now. And gets them just across the 37 of Hamilton in a first and 10. Ray is coming again quickly. Screened off to Jackson, who gets it up across the 40. Kept going. But the 44.
Well, get ready for the collision here between safety Royce Metchie and his former Calgary teammate, running back Dodd Jackson. Jackson, not the biggest guy. 5'10", 205, but kind of bringing a load there.
Jackson picked up seven, second and three, handing off to Jackson. Ray among the Argos coming in, and ultimately Enoch Mwamba in there too, and he did not get there. They're still shy a couple of yards for Jackson that time, so Hamilton will have to punt it away. Domagala coming out. He'll be kicking it from about the Ticat 30.
Well, big stop for the Argos, having pulled to within a field goal on their last possession.
Brandon Banks is standing back at the Argo 20. Defense doing its job. Domagala kicks it away, and Banks takes it at the 30. 35. Out of bounds around the 38. Simone Lawrence back after missing a month. We'll hear more about him coming up from Matthew here in the CFL on TSN. Leading tackler in the history of the Hamilton Tiger Cats. He passed Rob Hitchcock last year. If you ask him, he should have been back last week. Let's go back to Matthew.
Yes, Rod, he should have been back last week, according to Simone Lawrence. He was in practice. I asked Orlando Steinauer if at 33 years old he's had to tell Simone Lawrence to maybe slow down. He said, no, I last week went up to him and said, you're not going this week. And all Simone did was extend his hand, shake his coach's hand, and look him right in the eye. Now, I've covered Simone Lawrence for a decade. I can tell you,
that I've had that handshake. It's not a floppy fish. It is a very vigorous handshake and the look in the eye. And Smoy Lawrence is keeping that intensity tonight. Big second half right now, Rod. We'll see, though, if he keeps that intensity and what it does for the Ticats.
Matthew, I loved it when we were talking to Orlando Steinauer about it. He said, if Simone said he's ready to go this week, that means we're going to rest him for another week. Such a competitor. Wanted to go even if he is injured. And Ted Laurent with the tackle there. And Andrew Harris with the Argos with the ball and closing it to within 3 points now.
Nice first down run there for Harris. And you get a little bit of an idea of the strength of the Toronto Argonauts running back. We've seen a couple of times, you know, even the big bodies, Ted Laurent, Micah Johnson, it's not easy to bring Harris down.
Oh, Roll stepped in front, in on Banks.
Oh, Speedy, you grabbed his oar, Speedy!
And the trash talking goes too. You can be sure he knew that was coming.
Yeah, that's... We heard them yelling from the Hamilton sideline. You grabbed his arm, Speedy, and I think that's what Roll was indicating as well, that he thought he had a line on a pick, but was only able to reach with one arm.
So Haggerty punted away. Lawrence Woods lets it bounce, heads back into the end zone, and it's a good result for the Argos. He's out of bounds at the 3. Eli Mintzer coming in on the punt coverage. Woods let it hop and it ends up being great field position for the Argo defense. Hamilton has to start deep.
And this is a puzzling one for me by Lawrence Woods. If you're going to let it bounce to go into the end zone, and it looks like it's going into the end zone, then let it go. This field position, real tough place for the Cats to start the drive.
Works out perfectly for the Haggerty punt as Woods ends up at the 3. Dane Evans in that offense starting deep in their own zone. Another injured player is down.
A big opportunity here for the Toronto Argonauts.
That's Bailey Feltmate, backup linebacker, special teamer for Hamilton. Went to school at Acadia.
Sir, one of Jeff Cummins' guys. Former Axeman. You know, Bailey trained a little bit with another former Acadia product, Mike Miller, in the offseason. I'm sure he picked up a few of Mike's tips and tricks of the trade, life on CFL special teams.
If you're going to learn a thing or two about special teams, Mike Miller might be your guy, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
The all-time leader in special teams tackles. Still getting it done for the Blue Bombers. So Bailey Feltmate has helped off. We're about to resume this game late in the third quarter. Under 3 minutes to go. So three-quarter time. It is Hamilton 17, Toronto 14. And the Ticats are starting deep. Next week, these two meet again. 6 days away on a Friday night at Tim Hortons Field. And then they get a 1 week break from each other, and then they meet in back-to-back weeks again. And the Labor Day Monday, the traditional meeting. Lots of football before that. Play fake off to Jackson. And he gets tackled up around the 9. That is Winton McManus bringing him down.
Yeah, looking for a high percentage play there to try and move it out from under the shadow of those goalposts. Second and short situation here. Decent start for the Ticats for this drive. Nonetheless, critical second down play here.
I was going to say, any given game has so many important plays. You can count this one coming up among them. A second down and short is the Argo defense trying to force Hamilton to kick it away from the end zone. Do it. Great defensive work there for the Argos, and Dwayne
looking for another quick hitter to his fullback, Jake Burton, the flat. There you see Dwayne Hendricks. From his deep tackle spot, he lines up out wide. Nice job fighting off the cut block of the guard, Colter Wood-Manzi, and getting his hands up. Use the hands to play off that cut block and then react.
Dwayne Hendricks, second year out of Pittsburgh, and Michael Domagala. They're so deep, he gives up the two and makes it a one-point game, 17-16. The Ticats choosing field position over score right now, still having the lead by the narrowest of margins.
And we go back to the decision on the punt, where they could have given up one. They end up, as a result of the decision to field it in play, end up giving up two instead.
Declined anyway after the safety. Argo football. They will scrimmage from their 40-yard line. Now down only 1 point after the two were given up by Domagala and the Ticats. The chopping wood mentality of Dylan Wynn inside up front. Great tackle for Hamilton. From the 40, Andrew Harris picks up three or four. Simone Lawrence in on that tackle, adding to his total.
You see Simone Lawrence coming from right behind that goalpost. Andrew Harris from the backfield. These two new acquaintances. Good anticipation by Simone. You see him sort of duck under the guard, Gregor McKellar.
Just 36-yard rush for Harris, still twice as much as he had last year. Quickly, Temple Thompson gets it away to Phillips with a touchdown earlier in this quarter, following a long reception, and that one gives them a first down around midfield.
A lot of very experienced veteran receivers on this Toronto Argonaut team. You look at guys like Eric Rogers, Brandon Banks, Tavares Daniels, Marquise Ambles. And you see Curly Gittens and Cam Phillips seeming to emerge as the favorites for McLeod Bethel Thompson.
First down, another catch. Richard Leonard right there and Eric Rogers. Rogers hangs on to it. And it'll be second and short again for Toronto. 9 yards. And Rogers' first game back with the Argos this year. Injured to start the season. His 2022 debut. Wearing number 24. Final play, third quarter, second and inches. Bethel Thompson didn't need much. Didn't get much. Shy of the 45 of the Ticats. See where they spot it. It was a second down play, and it's a first down now. And that is the quarter. So they'll switch ends. And we've got a big fourth quarter coming up in the first meeting this season between the Argos and Ticats. Hamilton looked in control. Toronto came back. Phillips catch. Touchdown Toronto. Now just trailing by one with 15 minutes to go. It's here in Toronto. After one, Dwayne, we were talking about how poor Montreal's or Toronto's offensive stats were. Well, they've certainly picked it up a lot in the last 15 minutes.
Yeah, they have, closing the gap. And you can feel it, just the way the momentum had went in the third quarter of this football game. Toronto making big plays. Hamilton unable to get a whole lot of traction. You wonder if there's that psychological feeling for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, given what the trend has been for them in the second half of ball games this year, if there's a feeling of here we go again, or if there's a confidence that they can stem the tide here a little bit.
And you're talking about really two trends colliding, not just Hamilton's tough fourth quarter is where they've given up leads, but Toronto has had a knack with their three wins of coming back after falling behind. Trying to do it again. And this little play fake to A.J. Willett, and Bethel Thompson takes off himself, gets it down inside the 40 at the 37-yard line. Came in with 17 carries for 76 yards on the season.
Yeah. Mobility at the quarterback position. You don't necessarily have to be the most athletic guy, but I think having a mentality of understanding when to use your legs as a weapon is so valuable in this league.
Yeah, three carries of 10 or more this season, throwing that time beyond the reach for Marquise Amos. So it'll be third down, and they're about 2 yards shy.
Eric Rogers in his first game of the year, veteran presence. You get an idea of what he brings to the table. Veteran receiver. This is a guy who's a couple times in his career has hit double digits in touchdown receptions. Asked there to pick up a blitzing linebacker, he says no problem.
Morris Beatty's 2 for 2. Longest, 44. To the holder, John Haggerty, had trouble getting it down before Beatty could make the kick. So that's not on Beatty as he put that way left. They had difficulty between the snap and the hold here.
You sort of caught the tail end of it there after the snap. One hawk back to Haggerty. He gets it under control. Gets it on the tee. You know, but it's such a timing operation. I have no doubt that throws Boris Beatty a little bit. But.
Ticats fans enjoyed it. They do get a point to tie it at 17. We're all even up. Ticats ball starting at their 40. Into the hands of Lamar Durant, who is another catch. And this is second game as a member of the Ticats. And this is what we're talking about, how Hamilton can start strong and then in the second half start to fade, and their worst quarter is the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and Orlando Steinauer has tried to take measures to, in terms of the way his team practices and so on, to try to prepare them better.
Pump fake, deep ball down the right side, and it's incomplete. Keandre Smith was the intended receiver, but two Argos were there, McFadden and Mechie, in the coverage.
Yeah, no love lost there between a couple of former Guelph Griffins. Smith and Mechie getting over there to help out, breaking that one up. Rivers McFadden with the primary coverage on the play.
And so with that, in this tie game, the Ticats go 2-0. Early fourth quarter. Michael Domagala.
Trevor Hoyt, the backup linebacker, second-year man out of Carleton, who had the big block right up the gut. Argos overloaded the left side of the protection. Ticats unable to adjust. Here you'll see quite the number three man there of five on that side, only three on the other side, the interior of the protection. Hoyt comes free, does a nice job getting to the launch point. He has the block, Benoit Marion, former Montreal Canadien, with the scoop and score.
In his second year with the Argos, Marion, and a lineman's dream too. He's on the depth as a defensive end, but on special teams, and enjoying that opportunity after the Hoyt block punt. Marion, scoop and score. Marion has suddenly put Toronto ahead by 7 points. At one point, it was 13-0 Hamilton. Back come the Argos, including this block punt, touchdown.
I'm sitting here missing you, sipping this 80 proof, getting my first taste of gone.
No sooner had we talked about the Ticats' struggles in the fourth quarter than this. Benoit Marion still out there on special teams. His biggest special teams play in his football career, I'm sure, just happened. They're fired up on teams. Lawrence Woods on the return and head over heels at the 25.
We'll take a look back at the block, and you've got a little bit of confusion in the blocking scheme for Hamilton. You've got the first man taking one, both the deep back and the tackle go out to the second man. That leaves Trevor Hoyt, the third man, free. Cross signals as they've got enough over there to take care of business, but just some miscommunication there between Thomas Erlington and McDonald as they both take one guy. Hoyt ends up as the free man. Coming through as you've got two Ticats taking the next guy out.
And as you talked about during the break, Dwayne, we got two former Carlton Ravens teammates involved in that with Trevor Hoyt blocking the punt of Michael Domagala.
Right, finding themselves on different sides of this battle.
Benoit Marion.
Tough special team stretch there for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Between the decision to field the punt that led to Hamilton having to give up a safety, and then shortly after the blocked punt.
And another injured Ticat down on the field. They're calling for the cart in this case as well. Not identified the player who was down.
Take a look right here at the two-man wedge. The man on the left, rookie defensive end Anthony Federico. Takes a pretty good shot there. Big collision. Right at the point of attack there. Federico, Niagara Falls native. Great, hardworking young man.
They tend to Anthony Federico. We'll step away from a moment. Field with a very encouraging sight. That's rookie Anthony Federico, who does eventually get up after being tended to and walks off the field himself. The rookie out of Queens, taken in the draft in the second round, 17th overall this year.
Federico, defensive lineman by trade, is the UA leader in sacks last season with 7.
Samson football. At the 25, play big and quickly. The slant to Dunbar, just across the 30 now. So second down and four coming up after that 6-yard gain.
Well, the pressure gets ratcheted up even a little bit more on the Hamilton Tiger Cats here in the second half. Lots of time left. But we're feeling a little bit of a state of shock with the suddenness of the Benoit Marion touchdown.
On the second down, Evans off to the right. First down, Sean Thomas Erlington, who was injured on the opening kickoff, comes back and helps the Ticats move the ball here up to the 40 and across. Spotted it near the 43.
Yeah, quick hitter, free release to the flat for the running back, Sean Thomas Erlington. He does a nice job fighting off the initial attempt by Winton McManus to pick up that first down.
Evans again to Dunbar. And after the catch, might even lose a yard. The Argos had that read perfectly.
Yeah, and you heard Ja'Garrett Davis talk to Matthew Schnetti at halftime about running from the box and Hamilton with the misdirection type plays, and you know how they've got to rally to the football basically, and you see it here. That's exactly the kind of play this is for the defensive linemen, interior box guys, as they're trying to get upfield when they read pass, but then you got to redirect and get out wide on the hitch. McManus doing a nice job getting out to help out on that.
They spotted for no gain after that to Dunbar, so second down and 10. Fourth quarter. Evans checks it down to Don Jackson. Not enough for a first down.
Well, this is exactly what you're looking for when you're Toronto and in a second and long situation. You go three-man rush, drop everybody into coverage, and anticipate that essentially the quarterback is not going to be able to find somebody open on a deep enough route to pick up the first down. You force him to go to the check down here, and everybody can come forward to make the tackle.
Brandon Banks bobbling it a bit at his 20. Goes to the left, cuts back to the right, nowhere to go, and good coverage by the Ticats right at the 20-yard line. Late flags coming out. The kind of penalties that will infuriate a head coach.
If they'll flag both teams here, because it looked like it was a bit of a wrestling match. Malik Kearney kind of had the final takedown, but looked like he was hit right by the pile by a Toronto player.
There are two fouls on the play. Major foul, unnecessary roughness, number 44, Toronto. That is his second misconduct foul. He's disqualified from the game. Major foul, unnecessary roughness, Hamilton.
So they didn't announce the Hamilton player, Brandon Calver, special teamer.
On Hamilton, it was number 93, also a misconduct foul.
You see, as the tackle is made, Calvert sort of goes to, looks like, push Kearney by the pile. Kearney wrestles him down. Kind of a tough one because it's,
so Calvert's second misconduct penalty with that automatically out of the game. As you see him head to the breast. Heads backwards with that push. Javon Santos Knox and Mason Bennett, Simone Lawrence by committee pushing Andrew Harris back for a loss of a yard.
Well, this has been a rarity in the last quarter plus for Hamilton, getting Toronto into a second and long situation. They got to make a play here.
Approaching the midway point of the fourth quarter, the Ticats, who have led most of the game, now trail 24-17, thanks to a block punt, scooped in for a touchdown. Over beautiful catch for Cam Phillips, but a little bit high, and Jamal Roll is there to make sure he can't hang on to it.
Yeah, you're going to see Cam Phillips coming across your screen. Full extension, but just a bit high still. You see him with the Jordan-esque leg bend in midair there, trying to get a little extra hang time. But couldn't quite get to that one.
So John Haggerty will kick it away deep in the Argo end. Lawrence Wood standing just inside the Hamilton 35. Cats trailing by 7. 8 minutes to go. Woods with the ball. 35, 40, 45, 50. Ball comes out. Mason Bennett, though, has it in his hands, and they pick up even more yardage to the Argo 50, and a lucky break for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Woods had a very good return going, and then he lost the ball. Could have really hurt Hamilton, but the bounce went their way. Mason Bennett picking it up.
Need art support?
End of June, look who's back for the BC Lions tonight. Brian Burnham and the Leos take on the Edmonton Elks. That game coming up right after the Tiger Cats and the Argos.
And Kate, not done yet here at BMO Field. Hamilton trailing by 7 with the ball, getting a lucky break after a fumble on the punt return. They hung on to it. It's at the Argo 50. We are halfway through this fourth quarter. Dane Evans, a play fake to nobody. Throwing it from midfield and throwing it deep. Oh, and in and out of the hands. That is the recall. Royce mentioned the Ticats wanted one.
There you see Tim White, the intended receiver. Dane Evans takes a shot as he sees a bit of separation. Mechie gets an arm on him. If you see the tail end of this, there are other Argo defenders running in.
Hamilton is challenging the previous play for defensive pass interference. The play will be reviewed.
Rolando Steinar and the challenge, thinking that Mechie interfered. 14 of 19 in his career, a very good percentage on challenges, and that success rate.
He's definitely got a shot here. Big play. One of the interesting things to me at the tail end of this one, as you'll see as it bounces off the pads, there's contact a split second early, as you saw there.
And the command center's made a quick decision, and here it is.
After review, there was defensive pass interference by Toronto. The ball will be placed at the 12-yard line. Automatic first down, Hamilton.
So Royce Mechie on a challenge. Steinar wins another one. And it is pass interference. And here come the Ticats on that PA. They are, or PI, excuse me, they are threatening down 7 points. With the ball at the Argo 12.
We'll see if this is just the kind of break the Tiger Cats needed. With momentum definitely working against them here in the second half.
Trying to turn their fourth quarter fortunes around on the toss to Jackson. Taken down. Ball comes out. Whistle blown. They say the whistle had gone as it spiked there by Hendricks.
And this is a play that is essentially a race to the outside. Race to the perimeter between Don Jackson and a couple of his blockers and the Argo defenders. Jagera Davis and his double blue teammates definitely won that race. And you see Jackson in control of the ball until he hits the turf.
Had clearly hit the turf before the ball came out. So Hamilton, second and 13 after that loss of 3 with time to the right. Complete to Jackson at the 10, just inside. So instead of taking a shot at the end zone, they're faced with a field goal situation here. Down 7 to see if they can close it to 4.
And not in a hurry to send that field goal team out here on third down.
They're just playing three down football here by the looks of it.
Yeah, I mean, just over 6 minutes left. Field goal team comes out. You know, I think there may have been a brief debate about, are we going to have a better chance than this to score a major, but they want to make sure they get points out of this.
Steinauer clearly thought about it, though. It was a while before the field goal team and Seth Small came out. Matthew Schultz to hold. And a short attempt is through, and a perfect night continues. Seth Small, 17-yarders. And it's a 24-20 Argo lead, still 4 points, 6:07 on the clock here at BMO.
Setting up for a great finish here. Now up to the Hamilton defense. After that field goal closes the gap, Mark Washington's unit looks to keep that momentum turned in Hamilton's direction.
When Hamilton gets inside the 20, they've had 4 trips. They have 1 touchdown and 3 field goals. So having trouble finding the end zone. The Ticats settle for 3 there. Cam Phillips completes his case, says he caught it, but no. Incomplete it is, and a 2nd down and 10.
Yeah, Phillips tried to get the hands underneath, but that one just came out low from Bethel Thompson.
Ball is right at the 40. After that field goal and a 2nd down. Bethel Thompson with time and complete. Up at the 50 and a 1st down, Tavares Daniels.
Tavares Daniels working up a yard or two past the 1st down marker, giving himself some leeway to work back to the quarterback on the hook. Still pick up that 1st down.
Just shy of the 51, Argos. Andrew Harris. Quieter night, certainly by his standards. And that Ticat wall, Julian Hauser in there. Having trouble running the football for the 2nd straight game. Harris has under 40 yards for the night.
Well, it's been tough sledding in Andrew Harris's bread and butter territory between the tackles, but they have had some luck getting the ball to the outside. Maybe not on 2nd and long here, but we'll see if they're able to extend this drive if they go back to the perimeter game.
12 carries, 38 yards. 2nd down and long. Bethel Thompson wide open. Brandon Banks has the catch. 1st catch of the night. 1st catch against his old team. 1st down.
He's out there with Jamal Roll. Roll pushes deep as Banks sits it down in front of him. Big 1st down for the Argos.
And a gain of 15, yeah. For 16.
Into Ticat territory.
Right down to the 41, Hamilton. Trying to answer back. Hang on to that lead. Little flash and fake. Hauser chasing Bethel Thompson. Gets it away and completes it. Inside the 15. Down near the 10. Tavares Daniels with the ball. And here come the Argos.
Great response from McLeod Bethel Thompson. And the Toronto Argonauts. You see now as Bethel Thompson gets pushed out of the pocket, he's moving to his right. Richard Leonard had pretty good coverage on Daniels, but kind of overran it. So you see him try to regain his footing there to get back to the inside to his receiver.
Gain of 30, Tavares Daniels, 24-20 Toronto. Down at the Hamilton 11.
We'll see if Richard Leonard had a little bit of help overrunning the ball on this one.
Hamilton is challenging the ruling in the field. They believe that was offensive pass interference by the number 80. Play will be reviewed.
Try to take a look right in the bottom left corner of your screen is that battle. Yeah, and a little bit of a throw-by on the part of Devaris Daniels. Let's see if we can read how much force he put into that. You know, I mean, there's definitely movement that looks like a push from Daniels' right arm. It's hard to tell. And you see the two of them downfield here, left side of your screen. Hard to tell how much force is actually behind that push. You know, if it's more of kind of a slap by. There you see right hand extends, right arm extends.
This is the second challenge, Dwayne, by Steinauer in a matter of minutes.
Yeah.
He won the last one, so. Does he win another one here? A decision has been made. Was it OPI by the Argos?
After review, the ruling on the field stands. And doesn't have a timeout anymore.
So Steinauer goes 1-1 on his challenges. Doesn't win that one.
Yeah, and I think that's a fair ruling, judging it as more of a guide by than a push by on the part of Devaris Daniels.
Well, that play got Toronto down to the Hamilton 11. And the last play before the official 3-minute warning. 2:48 on the clock right now in the fourth quarter. Andrew Harris. They continue to do a great job. Dylan Wynn right in there to take him down for nothing. Just another close CFL finish. Due up. And a second down under 3 minutes to go here in Toronto.
I never thought.
But coming up next, Kenny Lawler and the Elks will try to find a way to slow down these BC Lions. We'll get you, BC, right after this one.
Okay, we remember that opener. Nathan Rourke, James Butler, the explosion. The BC Lions offense against Edmonton. Great job on defense, too. So the Elks are going to make things a little different in their second meeting. But here, a look into the end zone, Bethel Thompson. And that is too far on a second down try there for Cam Phillips. All smiles with Richard Leonard covering him. So Hamilton's defense, the best case scenario was to hold Toronto to a field goal and keep it a one-score game with 2.5 minutes on the clock. And it appears that they have done just that. Third down coming up, and Boris Beattie is on. Beattie's last field goal try after a low snap for John Haggerty.
Scott Beattie, number 100 here for Boris Beattie.
Problem there. And the snap to the hole to the kick by Beattie. And it is again a 7-point lead. There's the head coach of the Toronto Raptors, Nick Nurse. He learned he enjoyed the CFL and struck up a friendship when the Argo head coach was Mark Trestman. He used to discuss coaching a few years ago. Trestman was here in 2017 and 18, and they had a good friendship. And Nick Nurse here for his charity golf tournament back in Toronto in this NBA offseason, and enjoying the game tonight with the Argos leading Hamilton by 7 here. It's a couple of minutes to go.
I think Nick's here looking to see if Sean Oakman wants to play a little power forward.
Yeah, number 2 Toronto is the tallest player in the CFL. There he is standing at 6'9" and got some power too. Yeah,
would you take the ball into the paint against him?
Me? No, definitely not.
I watched Sean Oakman in warm-ups last week. Their assistant, Toronto's assistant general manager, Vince Magri, said that Oakman's been lobbying to line up at tight end and short yardage. So he always goes out and does pat and go with the receivers in warm-up. And I saw him make a beautiful twisting one-handed grab, the one rep I saw him take. It's like, sign him up.
He is a force, not just tall, big and strong. And that Argo defensive line. And he's going to be out there. Just a critical possession coming up here. Hamilton Tiger Cats down 7. 2.5 to go. In the hands of Lawrence Woods. Across the 30. No, he got taken down before that. More good special teams coverage there. And that's the rookie, Daniel Adebaboye, the backup running back. Back up to Andrew Harris, who gives him some pats for that tackle downfield on the kick.
Yeah, the Toronto Argonauts have had a strong night on teams, as you see Dan Adebaboye fight off the block. Make the play, hometown kid. Contributing however he can for the double blue.
Drafted this year by the Argos out of Bryant University. So from the 30, Evans. Incomplete. Intended for Dunbar. Robert Priester was there.
We talked about the Hamilton Tiger Cats' troubles in the second half of ball games, particularly in that fourth quarter. You see that margin widening with the advantage gained by the Toronto Argonauts here tonight.
Second and 10. Was immediately greeted by Wynton McManus. Third down.
And this field position makes for a tough, tough decision for Orlando Steinauer. He looks like he's going to keep the offense out there. Thomas Erlington slow to get up again. Remember, we saw him down for an extended period on the game's opening kickoff after a collision with teammate Grant McDonald.
Right around such a difficult time with just over 2 minutes, you gamble and punt and hope you get the ball back when you need a touchdown.
Yeah,
or
I mean, the time would make it a tough decision almost wherever you were on the field. But further complicated, as you see Thomas Erlington taken down by Wynton McManus. But the field position obviously being so deep in your own end makes the decision tougher. But to this point, the Ticats have left their offense on the field. To put in the ball game in Dane Evans' hands here.
So Sean Thomas Erlington heads off under his own steam. 2:08 on the clock. It is a third and 10. And what certainly looks like first down or bust for the Hamilton Tiger Cats here. They need 10 yards. Oakman, that Argonaut defense, trying to stand strong. Put this game away. Looking downfield, intercepted. That'll do it. Chris Edwards taking it all the way for a Toronto touchdown.
A huge play for Chris Edwards and maybe a little redemption, as he was one of those guys that were pointed out last week. And some discipline issues led to the Argos' troubles, but Edwards deep just inside that goalpost. Come coming downhill, reading that route. Good anticipation as he saw Dane Evans rolling to his right and sort of positioning himself to throw back across his body. Edwards saw what was coming, started coming downhill. Again, nickel linebacker positioned essentially as a second safety on that play.
Beatty with the point after. Interesting, this comes for Edwards against Hamilton. The last time these two teams played in the Eastern Final last December when the Ticats came back and won, Edwards involved in skirmishes with fans afterwards. He was suspended 6 games by the CFL and was cut down to 3. So he couldn't come back until week 5, actually, for Toronto.
Dane Evans, it looked like he might have been looking deep at Tim White, who was headed down the middle of the field, and then almost looked like he saw Jake Bird at the last second and tried to fire it in there. Chris Edwards jumps it, comes up with a huge pick six.
So they celebrate here at BMO in the first of 4 meetings between these teams in 5 weeks. And it's going Toronto's way now. Since falling behind 13-0, they have outscored the Ticats 34-7. And Braylon Addison, such a big part of that Hamilton offense early on. For the night and to wonder about his immediate future and how bad that injury is. Hamilton has scored 98-29 in the fourth quarter or overtime this season.
This ball goes through the end zone untouched. So it'll be no point. Just want to go back to that last play. Keep an eye on Tim White in the slot. He's going to run to the post. Kind of a poster skinny seam here. And he's got a step on his defender. And that's where I think when you see Dane Evans' eyes just before he throws this ball, I think he's looking at White. I think he's looking deep at Tim White, and then at the last second you see his eyes dart to the left, maybe thinking under pressure he's not going to be able to get it far enough for White.
Looking down to the right deep again, and it is caught by Stephen Dunbar. Great catch, Dunbar, inside the Argo 50-yard line with McFadden right there.
Yeah, bottom of your screen. Dunbar goes over top of him and around the hand of McFadden to make that grab.
1:36 on the clock. Gain of 37. Evans to Dunbar. Not only needing touchdowns, needing them quickly. That one for Jake Burke, the fullback, falls incomplete. Second down.
You know, and Hamilton, reminder, battling injuries in that receiving core as we look at the Dunbar catch one more time. Good coverage. McFadden gets a hand in there. Dunbar just gets 2. So we're seeing Jake Burke play in the slot a lot. Braylon Addison out. Mike Jones as well.
Evans takes off after not being able to find a receiver. And is taken down by Big Sean Oakman after getting it down near the Toronto 40. The third and short.
And a gotta go situation here for Hamilton.
No question now, 1:19. They meet again in just 6 days at Tim Hortons Field in Hamilton. Some Friday night football in the rematch. The second game of 4. And that one, the intended receiver was Dunbar, but a bit of a mix-up. It falls incomplete. They turn it over on downs. And with 1:09 on the clock, the Argos can certainly put this one away with a 14-point lead.
You know, you focus on one game at a time in a series like this, but you have to be aware of the big picture of the series of games. And you got to say, this game to me, when you, especially in terms of injuries, there's been a big toll on Hamilton. When you look at the guys that you've seen go out of this game, limping to the sidelines for the Hamilton Tiger Cats.
Bottom line for the Argos, after losing to Ottawa last Sunday, they get back over 504-3 and reestablish a 4-point lead in the East Division. The flag coming out.
Too many men in the formation by Toronto. This is a 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
So whether intentional or not, basically you can't create confusion for the other team by having 13 men in the huddle.
Second down play gets it up to around the Argo 45, 103. Harris holding his left hand, looks to be hurt as he heads off.
Talk about the physical toll with these teams having several more meetings coming up.
So he's in a lot of pain, frustrated too with the, holding that left hand. A.J. Willett, the running back down for Toronto, with the carry in the first down. Get it up to midfield. So what happened to Andrew Harris on that previous play?
Keep an eye as he goes down to the turf here. He had his wrist kind of rolled underneath him there as he went down under some big bodies. Argos, by the way, able to bring in the American running back Ouellette in place of Andrew Harris, the Canadian. The Argos have started a couple of Canadians heavy in this game, largely because of their injuries on the offensive line. They went all Canadian on the O-line, where they would typically start two American tackles.
Isaiah Cage, Trevon Tate had replaced him. They're both hurt. And last week, Dejon Allen, the right tackle, getting hurt. And this could be it. They take a knee. It's round 1-4. But we score that round for the Toronto Argonauts, who came back from 13 points down and won it by 14. They meet again in Hamilton in 6 days. Part two of the doubleheader coming up as we go back to Kate.
All right, so the Toronto Argos, officially a record over 500 as we welcome you back inside the CFL on TSN Studios. The birthday boy, Davis Sanchez, Matt Dunigan, Milt Stegall, everyone ready to go here to chat this game. So the Toronto Argos, you know, terrible first half, then they're able to turn it around. I mean, this is just the East at this point, trying to figure out each one of these teams, but give credit, Chez, to the Argos in the second half of the game. Much better effort.
Hey, look, you thought they were done at halftime. Pretty sure we all thought they were done at halftime, and they came through and fought and battled, and let's give them their kudos. We don't know what's going on in the East. That's what I do know.
100%.
I don't know what's going on.
Well, hey, Hamilton punched.